good and bad people in every tribe. So we don't give a shit about your religion. We don't give a shit about your political party, about the political party you belong. To us, it is irrelevant. We don't support criminals. We cannot support a corrupt politician. Because these corrupt politicians in government, what they know is only their pocket. So why should I support any corrupt politicians? So we are for the truth, and we will die for the truth. The truth is our religion, no matter what. We are the wounded civilians. My people, I think it is time for Nigeria, for Nigerian government, the federal government, it is time for them to apologize to Lawrence Anini family. They have to put it on newspaper and say they are sorry for killing their son. Why? You might be wondering, why should I say a thing like that? Why would I say a thing like that? Tell me what Anini steal that Obasanjo did not steal. Tell me what Anini steal that Babangida did not steal. Tell me what Anini steal that Buhari did not steal. Tell me what Anini steal that Jonathan did not steal. El-Rufai did not steal. Tell me what Anini steal that Shetima, the governor of Borno State, did not steal. Tell me what Anini steal that Oshomole did not steal. My brother, whether it is gun and paper rubber, or gun arm rubber, paper and pen rubber, rubber na rubber, according to Ambassador Samuel Joseph. Thief na thief. This time, since somebody in Nigeria can steal 26 billion, they tell us it is an NPC contract, he signed it out without the right procedure. Who give a shit? What we know, $26 billion is missing from Nigeria account. And today, the man is still in office. Somebody padded our budget, Buhari first budget. Somebody padded it. Duruga, the person who blew the whistle, Jibrin, they sacked him, and Duruga is still in government. So, Nigerian government, it's time for them to apologize to Lawrence Anini, will be the greatest armed robber. May they apologize to him for the tertiary wedding. Anini doesn't even have a house in Benin. Anini doesn't even have his own house. We are not trying to encourage stealing. We are not trying to support thief. I just want to make a point that stealing is stealing. Thief is thief. It doesn't matter how you take thief out. Thief is thief. Anini steal from government during the time when they kill and steal from government, bust bank, even share some money whether they do that. They do them like small picking thing. Now we get the real criminal away there for government. And we people see that it will worship them. Well, that is part of the thing where I come here come talk about. But the main the cocoa thing where I come here come talk about is this. You know, the ACPA, that's a APGA political party where them say Ojukwu himself created, who just the party that just won the governorship election in Anambra. Abano and his gang, you know, Ojukwu's son just declare is now an APC member. For only God know the reason why. The man too, he wants up for the national cake, you know. So the governor there, they are all making noise. People are insulting the Ojukwu son. That is a coward, is this, he's not useless, fine. You people are right. That man is a coward. Must everybody be like his father? That man is not like his father. That man is a thief. He wants to eat from the national cake. He's a rogue. So he wants to go and wave the broom so that he will chop his own. So don't blame him. Is Abaino better than Ojukwu's son? They are all the same. Corrupt and useless and coward. It is this same Obaino who gave Buhari the go ahead to send Python Dance to come and kill his people. Yeah, it is this same Obaino, the governor, who gave Buhari the go ahead when they were doing their Python Dance. What did Obaino do? To me, both Obaino, the governor, and the Ojukwu's son, they are both the same. Let them go to hell. They are both corrupt, the same coward. Don't let them fool you. Don't let them fool you. Now people are shouting, why did you join APC? Let me tell you, this ACPA, the political party that won the governorship election in Anambra, is it not APC in the night? APGN in the afternoon, APC in the night. The first person, the Abano tank after the election, it was Buhari. He had been to Abuja to go and bow down to Buhari. The first person, he make it clear to the nation that he loved Buhari government. He even said that Buhari should come out again in 2019. Then you want to come and blame Ojukwu's son because he said he is now APC member. You are all the same traitor. You are the people selling your people. You are the people killing your people. You sell your people for positions. So all of both the Abano, all those APG party and Ojukwu's son can go to hell for all I care. It's the truth people like us stand for. I know people will insult me now because what I'm saying, who give a shit? As long as we still share one Nigeria, I have the right to say anything I like. This is democracy. If you don't like what I'm saying, to hell with you and Buhari. This is the truth I stand for. This is the truth I will die for. Let me tell you something. Like I said before, we don't follow tribal. We just say it the way it is. Now, I posted something about the criminal, the Buhari Asboy Osibanjo, the snake under the green grass. I said a pastor, a corrupt pastor, that he said they should buy him a cutlery, spoon, fork, knife to eat for 17 billion. I talked about it. People writing me text message, texting me, why should I? A certain Yoruba man said, he always praised me that I'm doing well and what I'm doing, what the my criticism is good. But the moment I start talking about Osibajo, he begin to change. He said, no, Osibajo, no. Buhari is the devil. Buhari is bad. Osibajo is a prophet. Stuff like that. He's a holy man. He's this. He's clean. He said, you know, stop. I said, shut the fuck up. Buhari is more better than that evil Osibajo. What do you mean? Buhari is more better. Buhari is evil, but more Osibajo is more evil, more wicked than Osibajo, than the president. You can't give me that shit. Osibanjo is part of APC. If we say APC fail, Osibanjo is the vice president. So he's among the people that fail. You cannot distinguish Osibanjo from this nonsense that is going on in our country. Osibanjo is part and parcel of this government. You cannot say Buhari is bad, Osibanjo is good. That is impossible. When Buhari said his python dance, go and be doing their stupid dance in Southeast, what did Osibanjo do? Did he say anything? He kept quiet. So when I posted these things, I criticized Osibanjo. All the nonsense Osibanjo is doing, all the money Osibanjo is stealing, it was during Osibanjo, they signed that 26 billion. Osibanjo should be telling us the role he played, that the 25 billion Baru stole. Osibanjo cannot pretend he know nothing about it. Your body was still in the hospital in London when that money was signed, when that contract was awarded out. They should be telling us. He should tell us the role he played. So it's for the truth. I posted something about Osibanjo. He called me, started talking nonsense. Then he said something about Okorocha, that tribalism. He now used tribalism. His tune, he changed his tune to, you know, that is saying, Osibanjo is bad, but he's more learned, more sensible, he's more, still better than a governor from the Southeast who built Starshaw, who built a corrupt president, who built Starshaw, stuff like that. So use that word. Do you know what happened today? The same Osibanjo went to the Southeast to go and thank Okorocha for building statue. The same Osibanjo. Osibanjo went there to be encouraging, Okorocha, yeah, you do well, the way they build the statue. They were all clapping, bodyguards everywhere. It's all over the news. Osibanjo went there. People have been condemning it. Learned people, politicians, good politicians like that, people are condemning that. Why should you be building statue? The money you are spending building the statue is enough for you to alleviate poverty in your state. Help the people out. Market women are suffering in the market. People are in the market right from the morning to the night, selling something that is not even up to 5,000, suffering there. You can help these people out with this money you are lavishing, building a useless statue of some corrupt politicians. Why can't Didn't you use the money to help your own people? Help the common masses? Help the wounded civilian? But Osinbajo is there. They are all laughing. Osinbajo don't give a shit about the poor. They call him a pastor. What pastor are you talking about? Osinbajo is the devil himself. Pastor for what? In what sense, pastor? What makes you think he's a pastor? This is a man. Somebody from his own congregation was beheaded. He didn't see anything. That evil of Osinbajo. So my people, let me be. I don't want to spend too much time here. Let me leave this Osinbajo stupid Osinbajo and his and Okorocha and Buhari and these people alone. Let me go to the north. Some time ago, the Southern governor, they had a meeting in Lagos. They said they were talking about restructuring. Ever since Buhari became the president by force, by wuru-wuru, he introduced 75% and 5% style of government. Ever since, the disunity among the Nigerian tribe is growing higher every day. So people are agitating for their own self-determination. The Biafrans is there. The Ododua is there. And even the South South is planning. People are agitating for self-determination. They don't want to be part of this Nigerian fraud again. So our governor had a meeting few months ago, two months now, a month plus. They had a meeting in Lagos, you know, pushing for restructuring. Well, we said, okay, because Nigeria, the way Nigeria is going now, Mokini walk by body chop, the poor getting poorer. This rich getting richer, something has to be done. This corruption is too much in Nigeria. We got to restart again, or let every job go down at least. If we do better, if there is better restructuring, which some people think is going to be impossible. Because when you say restructuring, it will still pass through Senate. But some people like us still feel, okay, let's try it first. Something must be done. We cannot just remain like this. Especially this agitation in the Southeast. We have to do something that will make our brother in the Southeast, people like us from the South, to feel some sense of belonging. Now, I was surprised yesterday, the stupid governor, Shettima of Borno State, he said it so clear. He said those people calling for restructuring, they should forget about the restructuring is nonsense. That's the word he used. There is no restructuring. The governor of the South governor, this is not South governors or South East governor or South West governor. The whole South governor had a meeting calling for destruction. One stupid governor from Borno says it is nonsense. He didn't even say it with style. He said it is nonsense. Up till now, I am expecting our governor from the South to retaliate, to react. He said it is nonsense, no destruction. You know, we all know that they like Nigeria the way it is. They own the Senate. They decide who will be president. They decide everything. So they just like Nigeria the way it is. They just want the oil. It's what they want. They are benefiting from the disunity among the South governors or South people. I'm expecting by now any governor from this side, from the South, to react and say, no, don't say that rubbish. I just want my people to know the kind of Nigeria, the kind of people you guys are sharing country with. That is why I'm saying what I'm saying now. I'll be talking about the slavery in Libya. I'm going to talk about the slavery in Libya, but not here. I'll be talking about the slavery in Libya in very soon. Because they said some of them have been released. People like a pastor like T.B. Joshua, the governor of Edo State, promising money, land, whatever. The pastor T.B. Joshua, you know, giving them some millions. I said, thank God, pastors are beginning to give help from the money they are getting from the church, the tithe and offering those billion. These guys are used to enrich themselves. At least, thank God for T.B. Joshua. He's bringing something out of it. After all, you know, this what other criminals, all those criminal pastors, people like Christopher Ilome, Oyedipo, you know, Oyedipo, all of them should come out. At least it's time for them to head too and stop using touch point to enrich themselves. We are for the truth. You might not like what we are saying, But we are for the truth. Truth is our religion. Truth is what we stand for. And we must die for the truth. Yeah, we must fight. If it is to die, we are ready. People, I was surprised today. Obasanjo just said he still has his PDP card. I said, you destroyed it before. It's on the news, though. I'll still verify it. I've seen my guys, my Wooden civilian crew, will still investigate it if it is true. I saw it on the news today that Osip Basen just said he still have his PDP card. Say why? You said you fought against the party that made you a president. How can you still tell us you still have your PDP card? You tore it. We all saw it. People were talking about it, criticizing you, insulting you. Why should you tore your card on national television? You didn't see anything. 2 years after you imposed Buhari on us, you are not telling us you have PDP card again. What is going on? What is wrong with our politicians? Are you saying you have PDP card now to come and fight Atiku? Because you know why? We are for the truth. Oh my God. We are for the truth. Now, somebody posted on my wall and say, Atiku is a political prostitute. That he come from camp to camp, stuff like that. They come from this party, when you see there is no way they come to another party. I say, okay. Buhari did the same thing. Buhari tried to be president 3 times, he failed 3 times, with different parties' name. He was in one party like that, he came to another party, he tried 3 times with different parties. So, everybody have right to the camp, you want to camp. They call him all kinds of names, corrupt, is this, nobody should take him serious, let him go to where this and that. I say, Wait a minute. When Atiku was in APC, he was good. Then he was not corrupt. When Atiku was in APC, he was not corrupt. But the moment he left APC, he's not corrupt. What the fuck are you people talking about? If APC want to fight Atiku. Fight him well. Don't tell me corrupt. Because he was with you before, you never say he was corrupt. Banikoro, APC have been looking for Banikoro. They said he stole a lot of money. And my Banikoro now have his own broom in APC. He's not corrupt. Is it Ojikalu? Is it Ojikalu? Who stole a lot of money? Now he's waving broom in APC. He's not corrupt. Why is it that the moment somebody leave, somebody dump APC, the person became corrupt? Or when somebody dump PDP and decamp to APC, he become corrupt with PDP. When he decamp to APC, he become a saint. What is going on? So when we talk about these things, we don't just say it because of tribe. Buhari have come to destroy this country. And we must fight until Buhari must not come again. I don't care whatever party that is, as far as we are seeing the same Nigeria. I don't care whatever party that is bringing anybody, not Buhari. 4 years of Buhari, we can take 4 years. We can't take 8 years. We can't take another 4 years of Buhari. It cannot happen. We must fight to measure we kick Buhari 2019. I don't know how. Buhari must go. That's just the what we are for. I don't care if APC is bringing another person or PDP bringing. I don't care. They are both the same political. They are all the same. 60% of APC today, they were former in PDP. So Buhari must go. Thank you.